Hi guys, Elizabeth from Wiegler, and today we're going to look at hreflang tags. Now, if you're setting up a multilingual website, it's absolutely essential that you implement hreflang tags. So that's exactly what we're going to look at today. But first, let's have a quick recap on what an hreflang tag is. So an hreflang tag is a little snippet of code that Google uses to identify the language of your page on your website and how it relates to other pages on your site. Without a properly set up hreflang tag, Google won't know which language to index your website with. So essentially, you could risk not being found by your new website visitors. And that's exactly what you don't want when you're setting up a multilingual website. Let's take a look at what an hreflang tag looks like. As you can see, there are three different HTML attributes within this snippet: a rel attribute, an hreflang attribute, and an href attribute. The href attribute specifies the page we want to tell the search engines about. In our example, it's the Canadian version of the example site. The hreflang attribute identifies the language and, optionally, the region that the page is intended for. In this case, the attribute en-cl tells us the page is written in English, en, and intended for users in Canada, ca. It's only essential to specify the language. You don't have to specify the region unless you really want to. You also need to make sure you use the specific two-letter language code within your hreflang tags, and that's the official one. Let's take another look at that hreflang tag. So the rel attribute tells the search engine how that page relates to other pages on your site. Alternate tells us, in this example, the page is a variation of another page and that it shouldn't be surprised if the content is similar to other pages on your site. So why all this talk about hreflang tags, and why are they actually important? Well, hreflang tags tell search engines that you have variations of the same content but in multiple languages. Firstly, they help with user experience. So essentially, because you've got hreflang tags, the right search results will appear for your new potential customers. This helps them navigate to pages of their interest in their own language. As a result, Google will typically rank localized web pages at the top of search results, so it's very important for your visibility. Secondly, it's really important for your international SEO. As we all know, duplicate content is really bad for your SEO overall. So no hreflang tags, Google might presume you just have a number of duplicate pages on your website and remove you from SERPs entirely, which would be really detrimental, again, to your visibility on search engines. So what have we learned about hreflang tags? They're pretty important for your overall visibility. However, something that's not so great is they're actually really difficult to implement. Even Google's very own senior webmaster trends analyst called them one of the most complex aspects of SEO. So if you're not a developer, you're going to need some basic code skills and some HTML knowledge to help implement these on your website. So as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, we're going to talk about how to implement your hreflang tags. There are three different ways you can do this. One, add them to your HTML headers. Two, add them in your sitemap. Or three, use a website translation software. So let's take a look at number one, add them to your HTML headers. If you're a developer or you're quite code savvy, then this one might be for you. First up, you'll need to navigate to the head section of your multilingual website. From there, you'll want to paste in your hreflang tags. The hreflang attribute on each page needs to include a reference to both itself as well as all its alternate pages in each different language. The hreflang code snippet you'll need to paste in will depend on what languages or regions you're servicing and your page URLs, but it should look something like this. This method can be a bit problematic because you're adding quite a few lines of code to each of your pages that your users won't be able to see, but will still have to download when they open the page. So if you have dozens of alternative pages, you can quickly see how this might become problematic for the user. And when they try and load your website, it could end up being incredibly slow. Okay, so the next one is your XML sitemap. Again, this is another one for those that are more experienced in terms of coding. Your sitemap is the document you submit to search engines that lays out a map of all the pages and files on your website to help ensure they're indexed correctly. If your site has no hreflang tags, you can add a snippet of code in here to indicate all the alternate versions of each page. It should look something like this. As you might have noticed, the structure is a little different here as we're working with an XML file instead of HTML. However, the basic idea is still the same. Each tag includes a rel, href, and an href attribute, and they're always bidirectional. Aside from eliminating unnecessary on-page code and ensuring your site speed isn't impacted, adding your hreflang tag this way ensures you're not going to make a mistake by editing your header, so this way is slightly more preferable. As we've seen, adding hreflang tags manually is quite problematic and especially not recommended for people that have no technical skills. So, have you considered using a website translation software? A good translation software such as Weglot automatically implements the hreflang tags for you. This is great because you actually don't have to do anything. All you have to do is install Weglot, get a multilingual website instantly, and behind the scenes, Weglot has automatically added these tags for you, so Google knows exactly what language your pages are intended for. It's simple, fast, and only takes a few clicks. You can find your specific integration here, which I've also linked below. And once installed, you'll have a fully translated website. Automatically added hreflang tags, language-specific subdomains or subdirectories, and plenty more to help your website reach international audiences. If you want to see if your hreflang tags have been added correctly, you can also check out our brand new tool. Our hreflang checker is available here, and this is a really easy way to see if everything is set up. And there you have it. Those are three ways to add your hreflang tags, some more complex than others, but we're always here to answer any questions. So feel free to leave a comment below or contact us at support@weglot.com. Until next time, good luck and bye.